Colorize this image. Let's see what it gives us. In about 6 seconds, voila, we have the picture. Now, this is not just colorized very well, but it's also regenerating the entire image. It's not just colorization. Now let's try some more prompts. Turn this into a night. Let's see if that works. Now this is very beautiful, very well done. Colorized it, it regenerated these images. It's not just editing in real time. And this is just perfect. This is absolute beauty. Look at that. It is nighttime. You have some Milky Ways. You have full moon. Now let's try to be a little bit more curious. I have this funny one, right? Add a UFO enter from outer space. Google AI Studio just killed Photoshop. You can do so much with this app, and it's all free. All of it. And that's only in 6 seconds. That's scary fast. Okay. Look at that. You have everything picture perfect, and then the UFO, which look a bit like fake. Let's try to make it ultra realistic. Let's see if that works. And it's taking it only like 7 seconds. That's quite a good time. Okay, so it continues to add on top of the other one, right? Well, none of us have seen UFO in real life, so who are we to tell what's realistic and what's not? But it can do the job phenomenally well. However, this one is very blurry, probably not the best. But if we check that one, the quality is fairly okay. For free, 7 seconds. Now, this is a Gemini 2.0 flash image generation experimental. Remember to put it on this one. And here you have to be an image to text, right? And temperature is where you decide the creativity of it. I mean, imagine this technology implemented into iPhone and iPhone camera and smartphone cameras. Let's add some more on it. Add some people watching UFO. Let's see how they react to that. There you go. It adds some people there. This is a little bit... Yeah, there's a little bit with the hands. But that's the problem with AI. It always have problem with hands. But I'm thinking, is it because we keep regenerating it? It comes to this point. Let's see if we could just try this one, branch from this. Okay, this is more realistic. Yeah, I think it did a fairly well job. This is how the front interface look like. It is important that you turn on Gemini 2.0 flash. The output should be image and text, and the temperature basically decide the creativity of it. It does a phenomenal well job, not perfect. The quality can be discussed, but let's try the visual storyboard. I took this prompt online. It's already generating an image. Okay. Oh, wow, this is pretty good actually. So if you're a YouTuber or a TikToker and you're making short films and short videos, I think this is something really important. This could be a game changer here. This is a very cinematic scene, and of course we can, you know, improve it and change it. It's very cinematic. Look at the angle of the camera. I think this is brilliant. This is absolutely brilliant. Look at that. Brilliant. This is just brilliant. I mean, the whole scene just works. This could be a part one, and then come in part two, and then part three, something like that. While he's walking, his hands should be up. Keep the same camera angle. Let's see. It's a bit blurry, but you can, you know, make it more high quality image later. But just the whole point is that it can generate these stories. Brilliant. And you don't need to remember anything. You can just come here in the library. All your prompts will be here. I've been experimenting with it a bit. And let's just try another one. Let's try to build on it. These images are not enough. For the same story, generate me more B-roll cinematic photos. Realistic images. Let's try to run the prompt. See what result we got. We get. This seems pretty okay. This is unbelievably good. This used to be a job for like hours on end, and now you can just get it there. But remember, you have to still use an upscaler to improve the images. I want to try this one. This is where Gemini shines, actually. Create 5 separate images from the showcase this character from multiple angles. Keep the character exactly consistent. You can see the quality is not that good, but this used to be a far difficult job. This is a very difficult task to do. You can further give it another prompt. Let's see what we get. So I want, the prompt is keep the camera angle close to his shoulder, right? So I want a over the shoulder view. And there you go. There you go. It's just perfect. But you have to upscale these images, and it continues. I asked for one, but why not give me 20? So far, it looks pretty good. Does the job. Let's try again. Give me a visual story of blueberry cake recipe, step by step. Let's see how good it performs this job. Okay, let's try this. Give me a step by step. Oh, okay. So if you specify it, give it to me step by step, it tells you basically everything. You can see how easy it can be to make cooking books or cooking TikTok channels or YouTube channels. The potential with this thing is enormous. And remember, all of this is free of cost, right? And every time Gemini or Google update something, they'll put it in there. And when I say they'll put it up there, it will be available to use, not just be there in a technical paper, which is great. I love reading technical paper, but it is very important to have it for use. And Gemini seems to does that so well. Even Apple integrated it recently. They have launched a Gamma 3, which I'll do another video on it. But I'll do a whole video on AI Studio. I've been saying this, so how to use it. But look at that. It gives you everything step by step. How it should look like. Just perfect. I mean, you can turn these images into a video via Kling or the other apps. Kling worked best for me. And yeah, well, you have everything ready. Now you're just effort away. Maybe in the future, a robot can do that for you. But I mean, this tells you the enormous potential this app have. We can also try the one with the birthday card design. Generate and design a birthday card with beautiful floor decorations. The text should be large and say happy birthday. Look at that. It's perfect, right? But what Gemini does so well is the text, because a lot of AI cannot capture the text, right? Gemini does it so well. So the prompt goes, generate me an ultra realistic photo of a teacher in front of a chalkboard with a text. This is an abnormally long sentence, which most AI will be unable to generate. And look at that. It is perfectly done. If you've been using AI, visual AI, you would know the struggle of how hard it is to put the sentences there. This is a game changer. And they just keep on adding things to it. Okay. Let's upload this image that I developed for a TikTok. So I'm asking Gemini to give me a side pose of this Viking lady sitting in a chair. This is phenomenal. This is just unbelievably good. The quality is not that good. The tattoos are a bit messed up. But the rest, I mean, it does the job well. It just does the job well. I mean, this is good. Give her a cup of coffee in her right. Okay, this is what you got. Let's try to zoom in. I don't know what is holding that. But also, I think they just provided her with an extra hand to hold that cup of coffee, I guess. And the qualities keep going down as you go, right? But they will fix that, I'm pretty sure. Give her a human skull in the other hand. If it doesn't get censored, this is going to be interesting. Okay, well, there you go. Gemini always provide the extra set of hands, right? So somebody's holding the skull, her hand is frozen, probably of the cold Viking winter. Another hand she probably chopped off on her endeavors, but it does the job. I mean, it understands the prompt, and that's what the point of this thing is. That's what the point is. Give her a rainbow coat. Okay, this seems a very enlightened and cultured Viking. Of course, with the skulls and extra pair of hands. Example, where is this Twitter user is trying to make this man smile. It turns out to be a hard job. Okay, then the prompt goes, all right, maybe a big smile. And there you go. It does the job and it looks perfectly natural. In another attempt, he's trying to make the good old meme come with some hairs. It seems to understand the prompts pretty well. Now he looks like Sam Bankman-Fried. Good. Adding color.
Are you hanging with Diddy? I think he's in there with you.
He is.
To the picture. And yeah, there you have it. It just works flawless. In another example, they turned the cat into a Batman in the meme. Telling Shrek to close his mouth. And for all intensive purposes, turn him into a massive blue smurf. There you go. In another example, the user asked Gemini to replace the green phone with pink in her hand, and it does the job phenomenally well. That will kill a lot of jobs in editing and what have you. In another example, a user asked, can you add some flowers to the table? In a mere 9 seconds, it generated flowers on the table. That's nice, but I prefer red tulips. And there you go. It's just that simple. It's just a prompt away. So this is a new format of video I'm doing. If you guys like these kind of tutorials, so leave a like and comment and share with your friends. Let me know if I continue to do these tutorials. The next one I'll do on how to use the Gemini, and then some tutorials on Kling and comparison for the video, the creative part of AI. So if you guys like that, let me know and I'll continue to do that. Or should I just stick to the news format? All right. Thank you.